Today I fucked up by getting injected by testosterone so I could become a man. So, pretty standard day. I initially thought 7 hours ago. I'd called up the local health center for a guided lesson on how to perform the testosterone injection last night, and they got back to me with an appointment today. Nice and efficient, what I liked. 3 p.m. rolls around and I'm in the waiting room. The nurse calls my legal name and we get to going over the usual stuff. What pronouns do I use? Should they call me by another name? Was this my first time? And other generally positive questions. This health center didn't specialize in gender variance programs, but the city I live in has a dedicated LGBTQ+ population, so this was a little nice surprise. I'd been given plenty of vaccinations during my life since my parents loved me, so I figured this would be equally fast and painless with a small stab in the arm. Haha. In all my discussions with my doctor, somehow the topic of the injections being administered in my thighs never came up. Luckily for me, the nurse noticed that the prescription was one that could be administered in either my thigh muscle or my arm fat. The initial plan was for me to watch her do it the first time, with the next time being one whereby she would oversee me while I did it myself, and all subsequent times being done by myself at home. Since I am lacking in fat almost everywhere, doing it in my arm would have been impossible if not dangerous for me to do it solo, so I requested that she do it in my thigh so I may at least see how it would be done. Most times when I have to be pricked by a needle, I simply look away and all goes well. Obviously, I couldn't do that this time if I was to learn. So I sat and watched for what felt like ages, as this thick yellowy liquid gets very slowly injected into my pinched thigh. Ah, at last, the last drop. I am now one step closer to becoming a real boy. You then have to keep the needle in for a little while. For a what? I'd describe myself as a man of patience, but this I know liked. After what felt like removing a fantasy sword in a dramatically drawn out moment, the needle had finally left my thigh. How are you feeling? A bit lightheaded. The kind nurse reassures me that I can take my time and continue staying seated. She mentions that sometimes the medication can leak out sometimes, and at this point, I recognize the all too familiar sensation of tunnel vision and difficulty breathing. I turned away from the nurse to partly release my mask in order to potentially allow enough airflow to stop the encroaching feeling. This was not one of my good days, unfortunately. Leaning my head against the wall, still facing away from the nurse, I muttered something about not feeling well, before experiencing one of the best naps in my life. Man, I'd been falling behind on my sleep due to early morning construction outside my apartment each day, but it was the nap to end all naps. What's that I'm hearing? Is my roommate watching TV again? She has it pretty loud. There's a lot of medical terms being tossed around. She's not one for medical dramas. Wait, when did I get back? Oh, shit. I'm not in my bed. I'm on the paper-covered examination bed in the nurse's office. One of my sandals is missing, the other is hanging off my toe, and someone's pressing their fingers against my jaw really uncomfortably. There are at least two other people besides my original nurse in the room now. No, I just want to nap. Just a little longer. Dead name, stay with me now. Fuck. I try protesting the fingers against my neck, but they stay firm as I can't really speak with them holding my mouth in place. Fine, I'll tolerate it, but you can't make me enjoy it. And that's when I feel a plastic tube trying to go past my throat. Nope, 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 I've watched enough House to know where this is going. My gag reflex may be weak, but it still exists. I somehow garble around the invader in my mouth that I'm fine and the tube gets removed. Thank Christ. Oh, now it's one of those oxygen masks. This seems excessive, but whatever. Eventually, the mask gets replaced by one of those nose things that gives oxygen, which, again, I find to be quite excessive considering this isn't the first time I've fainted in my life, and I did tell the nurse this. But I continue being the good patient and let the nice people do their job. By this point, I'm just annoyed I chose today to wear sandals and gently scooch off the remaining one to the floor. I can easily lift my head to survey my surroundings by now, which consisted of a decent number of new medical equipment, in particular an IV drip attached to my arm. Someone mentions my heart rate dropped to as low as 40, earlier I was in the 60s, and that I wasn't breathing for at least a minute. minute. Oh, now I understand their intense reactions. I intentionally make conversation with the individuals around me to show them that I am doing all right. I ask if it'd be fine if I sat up, but I get told it'd be best not to at the moment. Yeah, take it slow, I know the drill. I just want to go home and forget this commotion happened. The door to the office opens and in come the paramedics, who begin asking if I have a preference for which hospital they should take me to. Amid Canada and your efficient healthcare system. Just let me die from my embarrassment in peace. I relent and let the nice people take me somewhere to make sure I don't have anything serious. I know it won't be. My mother's side of the family has experienced this before, but since I don't have concrete proof that this isn't my anxiety finally trying to kill me for good, I go along with the whole thing. My original nurse was very kind to pack all my stuff together for the ambulance ride, and after getting into a stretcher I was brought to the hospital. Nothing special happens from there with the exception that I finally get a name for whatever these fainting spells I get are: vasovagal syncope, aka fainting due to a sudden stressful trigger. Yeep, yeah, that'll do it. Can't wait to see what'll happen next week when I have to go back again. /S. Too long didn't read. I'm a trans boy who fainted due to the dramatic performance which was my first testosterone injection. Life is pain and full of suffering, but at least the healthcare is free. Wait, hold up. Unfortunately, that's how a lot of injections work. Not trans, but type I. Some needles I can jab, slam the plunger down, and be done. But some kinds of needles it has to stay in for a 20 count or so. I can only imagine with the liquid being thicker that it would actually feel worse to do it quickly. As a cis male, I will now count myself lucky that I get my testosterone not by injection. If you get it in single dose vials, I rub them on my hands for a bit to warm it up. As it's oil based, I feel it gets a bit thinner, easier to pull with syringe and inject. Hope you can get enough needles to use one for pulling and new fresh one for injecting. It gets easier with time. First time I injected, I just saw YouTube tutorial and it took me like 35 to 40 minutes to do it. I also inject some HCG with insulin syringe. That is much quicker, less painful. Unfortunately, it's a multi-dose vial, but I appreciate the suggestions. At this point, I'll probably just have the nurse do it for me until I no longer feel like fainting from the experience. I mean, a little further south, paramedics would have shown up too. Very efficient here too. You just would have had to edit your title to include, and I ended up with a $5,000 hospital bill. $5,000 for an ambulance ride to the ER? You're gonna need to add another zero or two there, partner. Congrats on starting T, dude. Even if the process was a little eventful. Today I fucked up by removing a tampon in front of my sister and traumatizing her for life. Obligatory, this happened a couple of years ago. I was a teen in school and on one particularly busy school day I had one of the heaviest days of my period. I would go through the largest tampons super quickly and towards the end of the school day I ran out and had one tampon left which was inside me. I had to pray that I didn't overbleed. Yet as time goes by I started to feel my period bleeding past my tampon and into my underwear, so I just wanted to go home as soon as possibly so I could replace it. As soon as I arrived home I ran towards the bathroom and immediately tried to remove my tampon. In this state of urgency I didn't even consider closing the bathroom door, which was stupid of me. At the same time my little sister happened to see me. She was 5 years old at the time and she knew what periods were but didn't know what a tampon was. Because she was shaking in horror as she saw me squatting over the toilet ripping out this massive bloody tampon from my nether region. She immediately stuttered, "Is that your bone?" And before I could even process the question she ran to her room. I had to laugh. Later I knew I had to go and comfort her and explain what a tampon is. But my god, that must have been horrifying to her. She's much older now and still remembers that moment. As she remembers it, it kind of looked like I was pulling out a bone fragment covered in blood by pulling a tendon or something attached to it. Gross. TL;DR, my little sister happened to witness me removing a tampon. She thought I was ripping out one of my own bones from my vagina and was scared shitless. I don't live in a first world country, so I'm probably wrong here, but knowing about periods for a 5 years. No, really. 5 year olds notice a lot. If they have older female siblings, it isn't crazy that they would know something. My 5 year old son knows about periods because he knows a ton about nature, and he noticed blood one time and was concerned. So we explained it to him as best you can, a 5 year old, and we all moved on. Oh no. Lol. Reminds me of when I was a senior in high school. My friend's sister was in middle school and had a friend over. Well, little friend changed her tampon and disposed of it, not realizing they have a very nosy German shepherd. Brucey found it and shredding the tampon and applicator all over the living room. We panicked. We ran and picked up the mess before she could come down and see and be permanently traumatized. Being a young girl, it was already embarrassing when people knew I was on my period. This would have petrified her. Nether region, I imagined the Minecraft Nether. And this is the story of why she only wears pads in adulthood. Well, Bone was at least on the right track, I guess. Today I fucked up by bursting into laughter while playing piano in church. Okay, let me tell you. My parents asked me to play something on the piano for the church that they are in, and since I know a lot of the members, I agreed. It's a relatively small church, so I can see everyone when I'm on stage. My parents asked me to write a song on my own, because it should be something special. I'm not that good at playing the piano, so my song was pretty simple. So the moment arrives, I'm starting to play. The last week or so I had discussed with my brother why the melody was so familiar at one point of the song. I still decided not to change it, because I liked how it sounded and it wasn't supposed to be heard by any other people except the church members. And wow. I'm sitting at the piano, my gaze kind of zooming out. Now I'm looking the Jesus Christ statue right into his eyes when it hits me. I'm playing some part of the Jurassic Park theme song. Instantly I look at my brother, who had the same realization, and just start to lose it. Completely losing it at the thought of looking at Jesus and just hearing this song. I was so embarrassed, I will never ever go back into this church. My parents didn't understand why I was laughing, but at least they aren't mad. Too long didn't read. I watched too much Jurassic Park and accidentally included the melody of the theme song in a song I had to write for / play in church. Sorry for laughing, but that was just too funny. Don't worry about it too much, op. People will forget it soon, or they'll just remember it as a funny story to tell at family gatherings. As a pianist, this was the best read of my day. Wish I could have heard. I know where you're coming from. I've played piano in church settings for years, and let me tell you, the guy sitting on the front row at the early service when his pet squirrel gets out of line, yes, an actual live squirrel, he just smacks that thing so hard. He did it the one time I actually played in that service while I was right at the front of the stage. Promise I wasn't red-faced and sweaty for the rest of the song because it was hot in the room. Okay, but why don't I have a pet squirrel to go to church with? This is Gold XD. I'll cover it for you. We were sitting in church on day when I realized the organist was playing Billy Joel. I mentioned it to someone later and he told me the organist didn't think anybody would notice if he played it slowly. Sing us a song, you're the organ man.